But the gaming industry consistently moving closer and closer to digital-only formats, sometimes game preservation can be a topic on a lot of players' minds. And nowadays, with developers adding updates, fixes, or straight-up expansions to games that sometimes overrides or removes content that was once available, some players are left without access to parts of a game that once were accessible. But interestingly enough, Pokémon Crystal, which released in 2000, may actually be one of the most unique and earliest examples of a game that has content that may be lost forever that a lot of players are still searching for to this day. Pokémon Crystal released in Japan in the year 2000 and globally in 2001, and it took the original experience of Pokémon Gold and Silver and expanded upon it, adding a bunch of additions to the game, and kind of served as the ultimate version of the Johto Pokémon experience. And right before Pokémon Crystal was set to release, Nintendo had struck up a deal with the company Konami to form a new company that would focus on creating cell phone linking features for the upcoming Game Boy Advance. And while most of the projects that Mobile 21 ended up working on were incorporated to a couple of Game Boy Advance games, there were two games that specifically brought internet connectivity to the Game Boy Color. And while this wasn't the first attempt to bring the Game Boy to some level of online connectivity, this was the first attempt by Nintendo directly, and they were willing to let one of their most popular gaming franchise be one of the tests for the possibility of online features in a handheld. Okay, just think about how crazy of an idea it was to just take a simple game like Pokémon and try to find a way to add online connectivity all the way back in the Game Boy Color era. This is really mind-blowing if you think about it in the context of just how long it took for this to become a main staple in Pokémon around the DS generation. So just 1 month after Pokémon Crystal released, the official mobile adapter GB would release, and it actually brought some really unique and interesting features to Pokémon Crystal that was, at its time, completely unheard of in Pokémon, but also pretty revolutionary for a handheld console. Essentially, this adapter would be used to connect a Game Boy directly into a cell phone, and then from there add features by connecting directly to the internet. Players then would have access to a service that would allow for patches to be sent directly into Pokémon Crystal, changing things up like dialogue for certain non-playable characters. Players would be able to connect in-game and download various items that were never officially released alongside the game, like the GS Ball, and even get updates about other players who also use the online service. And then, interestingly enough, players would actually be able to connect online to other players and battle over the connection through the cell phones, which was something incredibly advanced for the Game Boy Color generation. And if you think about it, not a feature that was integrated into Pokémon until all the way in the fourth generation with the releases of Pokémon Diamond and Pearl. And it actually worked a lot like the GTS system, where you could post what type of Pokémon you're looking for, and then someone could trade their Pokémon over. According to the Lost Media Wiki, there actually were a couple of exclusive minigames that players could access as well by connecting to the service, like a 10-card quiz show hosted by some time-traveling character named Chico. And while some of these services had a fee associated with them, ranging from around 100 yen a month, while this service had a surprising amount of features and things that most people who played through Pokémon Crystal may have actually never known about. Matter of fact, these services would provide more additional content for Pokémon Crystal. Like in the service, you'd be able to update and change the battle tower in-game, with also online features to connect and trade Pokémon with other players in the country. We mentioned this earlier, but there was an event for the GS Ball, which would allow players to have access to summon a wild level 30 Celebi, which was a feature that just never even came to American audiences in the Gold, Silver, and Crystal versions. Now, this event would have required you to play some of the mini-games that were mentioned earlier on, and eventually Chico would give you the GS Ball. But to this day, it's still fully unclear what the backstory was during this event, and since the minigames technically took place off cartridge, If there ever was some sort of explanation of how this time-traveling character has the GS Ball and why they trade it over to players for the event, that's something we may never fully have an understanding of. This event was, of course, planned for the American version. It was translated and even modified to exist inside of the Pokémon Center instead of the non-existent Pokémon Communication Center, which was only in the Japan version, but then it never actually became a part of the game until the Virtual Console re-release of Pokémon Crystal on the 3DS, where after you enter the Hall of Fame, if you go into the Goldenrod Pokémon Center, the player will be gifted a GS Ball, and then from there they could do the rest of the event. However, those early parts with the mini games are still missing to this day. But then there were other events as well that were restricted behind this mobile GB service. And it could also lead to access to an egg ticket, which would be traded in for an odd egg, which would give a baby Pokemon that knew the attack Dizzy Punch, and according to Bulba Garden, also had a 50% chance of being shiny. Also, it's pretty cool if you think about it, how they tried to really up the ante with the types of connectivity that Pokemon could have as a Game Boy game to other devices, like the Nintendo 64 with Pokemon Stadium 2. One of the most interesting features, though, was something called Mobile Stadium, which came out a little over a week after the device launched, and would allow players who had an online battle record the data of the battle, and then from there they could transfer the data using the Nintendo 64 transfer pack. They could re-watch the battle that had already occurred through the Pokemon Stadium 2 engine. Kind of a cool way to bring Pokemon into the 3D graphics that was already in Pokemon Stadium 2. Pokemon Stadium 2 even had unique music just for these recordings, which would play a remixed theme or rearranged theme of the Mobile Center music from Pokemon Crystal. In the Japanese version of Pokemon Crystal in Goldenrod City, the Pokemon Center itself was actually transformed into the Pokemon Communication Center instead of the Pokemon Center that we see in the English translation of Pokemon Crystal. And it actually appears that there were plans at one point to give these online features to the international audiences who played Pokemon Crystal as well. On multiple occasions, several fans have gone into the debug menus of the original Pokemon Crystal game and have found various assets that still remain intact from this cut feature that are almost completely functioning with the exception of the text itself being translated fully. It actually seemed like for the most part, this service was intended to be more of a hub where you could access various different features across not only Pokemon, but the Game Boy as a whole. Now, the reason why this service never actually made its way internationally into America or into European releases of the game is likely due to the fact that overall the Mobile System GB service just wasn't popular enough to warrant the price of localization and manufacturing more of the devices. The Japan Economics newspaper, known as the Nikkei, reported that Nintendo had only managed to sell 80,000 overall units of the Mobile Adapter GB. And while the device was accessible in other games, Pokemon Crystal definitely was the main focus of attention for Nintendo with the product. And since at that time, Pokemon Crystal had a largely younger audience base, it was very unlikely that the audience that was playing Pokemon had access to a mobile phone. And therefore, it was announced at the end of 2002 that all of the online services for the Mobile Adapter GB would be discontinued at the end of the year. This would actually mean that all of the features that were originally accessible by connecting online to the device would no longer be functional, but the players who had connected during that time would still be able to keep all of their in-game updates, items, trades, and all of the gifts that were given out through the service. However, one key issue of Pokemon Crystal has kind of evolved this type of content into one of the biggest mysteries in the Pokemon fanbase as a form of lost media. But if we dig a little bit deeper and look a little bit closer at some of these things, we can start to realize why exactly fans from the Pokemon community have been looking for these forms of lost media for all of these years, and why it's so challenging to recover these lost events. While some portions of the various events that were only accessible through the Mobile Adapter GB have been restored through hacking or versions of emulation, the specific updates that provided DLC, things like what those battle tower changes were or what in-game dialogue was changed along the way, or various events that were different from other types of events that are found in the game's files. There was a mailing system with items called Blue Sky Mail and Mirage Mail, and the minigames that were all added into Pokémon Crystal are currently forms of lost media, because only a limited number of Pokémon Crystal players actually downloaded those into their game. Fortunately enough, there's enough players out there who experienced Pokémon Crystal's online services back in the day where we're at least able to have information as to what the service provided and what changes were there. But even if a player who had the game all the way back in the day and connected to the online service still had their game with the same save file on it, it's very likely that the game cartridge itself was corrupted. Since the second generation of Pokemon games utilized the day-night cycle, and the saves for Pokemon games were stored on the game's RAM, there is a small internal battery inside of Game Boy cartridges, but since the day and night cycle in Pokemon Crystal was always keeping track of the time, when it comes to the second gen series of Pokemon games, they were notorious for the game batteries going out and the game files corrupting. Meaning that even if someone accessed that and had all of the stuff on their save files, the likelihood of someone coming forward with a game cartridge that hasn't corrupted and lost all of their save data is highly unlikely. Now, of course, that hasn't stopped the Pokemon and Game Boy modding community from trying to attempt to recreate the mobile adapter GB service, or try to resurrect some of the stuff that was from there, and there has been progress made in finding some leftover assets and some remnants of what we could see from the original mobile adapter GB. Now, we've shown some of the footage on the screen throughout this video, and links will be in the description down below to all of the people who have looked into this even more. Some modders have even been able to reroute some of the data so that they're able to trade with themselves along the way, evolving an Onix to a Steelix, for instance, using the defunct mobile system. And while some of the features that were more reliant on Pokemon Crystal may be resurrected and salvaged someday, the events themselves and those patches that altered Pokemon Crystal may actually be lost forever. But if you liked this video, do consider subscribing to this channel since we're just getting started over here. Also, if you like commentaries like this on really interesting topics from the Pokemon universe, definitely check out some of the other videos we have on our channel.